डेफिशियंसी ऑफ एनी ऑफ द न्यूट्रिशनल एलिमेंट, से इट आयरन, से इट कैल्शियम, से इट विटामिन डी, एनीथिंग, देयर इज मिसमैच बिटवीन सप्लाई एंड डिमांड. इफ सप्लाई डिक्रीजेस आर डिमांड इंक्रीजेस आर लॉसेज इंक्रीजेस, देन देयर विल बी डिक्रीज इन द दैट न्यूट्रिएंट. लाइक इन सप्लाई देयर इज टू कंपोनेंट्स, इधर इट इज डेफिशियंट इन द डाइटरी कंटेंट इटसेल्फ और इट मे बी नॉट एब्जॉर्बिंग फ्रॉम द गट. ओके, तो सप्लाई कैन हैम्पर इन दीज टू लेबल्स, इधर इट इज डेफिशियंट इन फूड और इट इज मैल एब्जॉर्बिंग, नॉट एब्जॉर्बिंग फ्रॉम द गट. अदरवाइज इफ डिमांड ऑफ द बॉडी इंक्रीजेस, देयर आर सम फेजेस ऑफ लाइफ इन विच द डिमांड ऑफ सर्टेन कंपोनेंट्स गोज अप, लाइक इन ग्रोथ, लाइक इन प्रेगनेंसी देयर इज इंक्रीज डिमांड ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स. So it leads to the supply demand mismatch, and if there is a loss of nutrient more than the supply, then the pool will decrease. So there would be three main headings where the causes can intervene, like in decreased supply, increase in demand, or increase in loss. Okay, so if supply decreases, iron pool will decrease, leads to the iron deficiency anemia. If the demand increases, we will look after the causes where the demand increases, then the pool of iron will decrease and leads to the iron deficiency anemia. And same with the increased losses, if the loss of iron or blood will increase, then it will lead to the iron deficiency anemia. Then what are the causes of decreased supply? As I told before, it may be decrease in the dietary content, like if patient is taking inadequate diet, or it may malabsorb from the gut. Malabsorption may be due to the disease process, or it may be the surgical cause which leads to the malabsorption, like in tropical screw or Crohn disease. Achha, one most important thing you should remember, iron get absorbed from the proximal intestine, duodenum and duodenum mainly, proximal intestine. Any pathology which affect the proximal part of intestine will lead to the iron deficiency, otherwise there will be no effect on iron. If distal intestine is involved, then there is no effect on iron absorption. So any surgery which affect the any initial part of intestine, duodenum and jejunum, wo bhi proximal jejunum, like gastrectomy we'll cut the this stomach and proximal part, duodenum and proximal part of ileum, many of the cases. So the main absorption area of iron will reduce, so it will lead to the decreased absorption of the iron. Okay, in any acute or chronic inflammation condition, why there is iron absorption decreases in any form of systemic inflammatory disease, say it acute or chronic, comment in chat box why it is so that iron absorption decreases in chronic or acute inflammation. Okay, we will take it up after the lecture. Okay, the second part is it may be increased losses or demand or loss will increase. Like when the demand of iron will increase, if a patient is growing very fast, infants and adolescent grow very fast, so the requirement of iron increases. Pregnancy is growth of fetus inside the mother womb, so the requirement of fetus is very high, so the iron is shunted towards the fetus, so there is increased demand of iron. And if you are giving erythropoietin, what happens? Erythropoietin stimulates the erythroid hyperplasia, and if the erythroid hyperplasia is there, the erythroid cells are rapidly dividing, the mobilization of iron takes place and demand will increase, and this will further lead to the deficiency if not properly supplemented. Okay, there may be the increased loss may be due to the acute blood loss or chronic blood loss. In acute blood loss, like trauma, if the hemorrhage occurs, the blood will loss, along with the blood iron will loss, because every 1 ml of packed RBC contains 1 mg of iron, with blood loss, iron will loss. In chronic blood loss, which is most common form of actually, most common cause of anemia, it may be due to the some carcinoma, acid peptic disease. In our tropical countries, this is warm manifestation is very common, especially in children's, like hookworm infestation. Are in females, a special process is menstrual bleeding. In single menses, a female losses around 80 ml of blood. 80 ml of blood means a huge loss of iron. Or many a time, it cannot be supplemented with the oral iron, oral dietary iron. So these females subsequently develop the iron deficiency anemia. This may be the reason why iron deficiency anemia is far more common in female than male, because females are losing blood physiologically. Apart from the other causes which are common in male and female, like hookworm infestation, is female are not resistant to hookworm infestation. It can occur in them also. But additionally, they are losing blood by their a physiological process, menses. Okay. If someone is donating blood very frequently, blood donation is again a blood loss. Maybe for noble cause, but it is a blood loss. So with repeated blood donation without proper supplementation can lead to iron deficiency anemia. Phlebotomy is a process in which we draw the blood from veins. Like in polycythemia vera, it is a treatment, sort of treatment. But again, we are losing the blood. If you are losing a blood anywhere, means you are losing the iron. So if it is repeated many times, it can lead to the iron deficiency anemia. Okay, to summarize, the causes of iron deficiency anemia may be due to the decreased supply, that is decrease in the oral content, oral dietary content, or due to the malabsorption. Okay. Second, it may due to the increased demand in different stages, in different sort of subset of people, like one who is growing very fast, like in pregnancy, and in some cases, in fact, in majority of cases, it is due to the increased loss, maybe most commonly in the chronic blood loss. Okay, so